Dwyane Wade was much more than a great shooting guard. He was an explosive scorer, a clutch performer, a respected leader, and a true champion three times over. The 2006 Finals MVP, he is the Heat franchise leader in points, assists, and steals.
Welcome to the NBA, Dwyane Wade.
Well, D-Wade, you know, when I first went to Miami and I heard about this kid, Shaq had called me saying, come on down to Miami. I got a kid here that can play. Then when we got in the season, his determination and his ability to score the basketball and do the things that he did with the ball was amazing to me. But what was even more amazing to me is when we went to the finals with Dallas and he took over the whole championship series. He averaged like 35. He was making incredible shots. And I just went to the whole team and I said, look here, this young kid has a lot of talent and ability, and I think he's going to be a good one. We got to let him take over the game and do it. Shaq, you got to step back. You know what I'm saying? We got to give this kid the ball. And when we was giving him the ball, the things that he was doing was getting to the basket, shooting fadeaway jump shots, one-footed step backs and a jump shot that he was having, and running down the floor and doing amazing shots. I said, this kid has a knack for it. And when I seen that, I said, he's going to be a great one in the NBA.
Wade on a beautiful plus the foul.
There he is, attacking the rim.
Dwyane Wade reminds me of a superhero movie where a kid grows up and he does all these weird things and he does not know he has the power until he meets a powerful figure and they tell him, hey, you're just like me. D-Wade was a fabulous player when I got there. When I was, leaving the Los Angeles Lakers, I had the ability to tell them, I want to go to Miami. And the reason why is because we all watch other games. So during the playoffs, I'm watching Miami versus Charlotte. And D-Wade is giving it to my main man, Baron Davis. And I'm also the type, I don't really pay attention to who's who. Like, I always tell D-Wade, I don't even remember playing you during the regular season. And I used to love going to play against Miami because of Alonzo Warren. I never even seen him before. But then when I seen him, he had something that I seen before. And I seen it in Penny Hardaway, and I seen it in Kobe Bryant. So when I was getting traded, I said, I want to go to Miami.
Tom Crean was his head coach at Marquette. Tom Crean was my assistant coach at Michigan State. And for Tom Crean, the first time he talked to me about Dwyane Wade, here was a guy that was a 6'3 power forward at the college level that played that position relentlessly, just made himself into a better basketball player because of his work ethic. I got a chance to play against him at a young age. They beat us in the playoffs. And then the end of my career, my last year in the NBA, I got a chance to play with him. Dwyane Wade is one of those guys that will be described in his own box. He just did so much for the game, played it at a non-traditional two-guard way. You always thought of a two-guard as a scorer. He's one of those first guys that a two-guard had the ball in his hand, made his teammates better, athletically did things that we hadn't seen before from a guy that size and far as physicality. Dwyane Wade is one of those guys that just self-made himself into a first ballot Hall of Famer and one of the greats to ever play the game.
Dwyane shoots. No, he couldn't get it off. Now fires it up. Bank it in! It counts! It counts! The Heat win the game! Dwyane Wade won it for Miami!
D-Wade was somebody who I knew he was coming up the ranks. I remember my cousin Gabe told me about him when he was at Marquette, because I don't watch too much college basketball until he gets to the tournament. And it was about that time, and he started dominating. And my cousin was like, man, I'm telling you, he's from Chicago. This guard is just unbelievable. He dunks everything. He's relentless. I'm like, can he can dominate at this level? He's like, man, I'm telling you, Maul, like, he can do it. So to see the series he had against a prime Baron Davis, as a rookie, and to see his career, and those were some of my favorite battles.
I think I was part of sort of his coming out party, that 06 finals, where he really grew into the superstar he became. We couldn't handle him after, the first two games, and he was, he basically carried the team to the championship that year.
Rebound Wade! The Miami Heat, they win their first championship in franchise history!
Smitty, it is unbelievable to think a city that is as celebrated with a sports history as Miami, that Dwyane Wade is universally considered the best player that city has ever had.
You're right, Jared. I mean, from day one as a rookie, it became Wade County. I mean, as a rookie,
He led the team in scoring, only the fourth rookie to ever do that. But I think also just his impact in the community. Everybody loved him. He was out. He was doing things from a, I would say, giving back standpoint. He was a guy that you could see. You know, a lot of times stars, they don't come out. Dwyane Wade was a part of the fabric of the Miami Heat. And then you talk about his play. He did everything for the Miami Heat franchise. And that's the one thing, when you watched them when they were winning games and obviously winning championships, it seems like whatever they needed, whether it was defense, whether it was a block shot, one of the greatest guards in blocking shots in our history, steals, rebounding, and then even when you needed jump shots and threes, Dwyane Wade always came up with the big play for that franchise.
And he had to take the hard road to get to be one of the all-time greats, right? Not highly recruited out of high school, right. Came out of Marquette, and people really didn't know what to expect when the Heat took him in the first round.
Yeah, and when you watched him in high school and also at Marquette, he was basically playing a small forward slash power forward, then became one of the greatest two guards in the history of the game, and obviously the best player in Miami Heat franchise. And I think for him, is that's extremely hard work. Then obviously he got a chance to team up with LeBron and Chris Bosh and took that to another level, and that was selfless. This is when he was still Dwyane Wade, the all-star, to be able to have those guys come and take a back seat, did it all for that franchise and did it all for winning.
You know, you only could think what it would be like, you know, as a fan of the game. You're excited because you're like, man, LeBron, Chris, D-Wade all playing together, and this is for real. This is not just Olympics. This is for a long time. So as a fan of the game, I'm excited about the opportunity and possibility of what it can be.
I think it says more about his leadership than anything, because a lot of the times, in order to get better, you have to set your ego aside. And, you know, some guys don't even want to play with other all-star talent. They just want everything to be for themselves, and they'll sacrifice winning to do that. But Dwyane, he could have made every excuse to continue to kind of really just unquestionably be the man here. But, you know, he took on a huge responsibility in asking guys to come join him.
LeBron James hitting ahead for Wade. There he goes. Oh! The house of highlights!
You think these guys like passing the ball to each other?
I don't think that championship run really goes down the way that it did if D-Wade doesn't take that step back, why he was even willing to open up his house. That was Wade County, you know what I'm saying? And he opened the doors to his city and to his team, to LeBron and Bosh. And I can remember me personally talking to him like, how was you so cool? He was like, in order for you to fear something like that, you have to feel it some way. And he was secure in himself, and he was secure in what he had done in Miami and already what he had established, and he was correct. He had nothing to fear about bringing LeBron in. He knew what he was doing was only going to add to the legacy and add to the championship. And at the end of the day, I think the city of Miami organization and everybody that's involved and has anything to do with that, everybody understands what type of person and what it took for D-Wade to do that.